Michael McCann of Sports Illustrated joining us here on the Rich Eisen Show. Why won't this just wind up in the same way that it wound up with Tom Brady, Michael, and the fact that the Players Association can tell as many judges as it wants that what the league did was arbitrary, it's not fair, that the league is just red rubber stamping a decision that they decided to come up with because they want to look tough on domestic violence, and then it's the judge just reads the fine print of the collective bargaining agreement and says the league could do what it wants because you signed the CBA. Why won't it wind up that way?
It probably will. That's the most likely outcome if we go by the Brady decision, if we go by the Adrian Peterson decision. Ultimately, the judges looked at the contract and said what you just said, Rich, which is the fact is the NFL can more or less do what it wants with player conduct. It doesn't have to be consistent. It doesn't have to share investigative notes. It doesn't have to have witnesses testify. There's nothing in Article 46 of the CBA that mandates any of those things happening. And the argument the NFL would say, in court at least, is if it's so important to the players and their union, why didn't they negotiate for those things? Now, other judges, it's worth noting, have looked at this differently. Remember, two of the judges that Brady had ruled in his favor.
Judge Berman, right?
Right, Judge Berman. That's exactly right. And Chief Judge Katzmann of the Second Circuit ruled in his favor. Now, they weren't in the majority, but they said, wait a second, you can't just say if it's not in the agreement, it doesn't exist. There are certain basic elements of fairness. We don't know what Judge Mazant's going to say. Maybe he's in that school. Maybe he's in the other. We'll find out.
Okay. So why New York? Why is the league filing in New York, Michael McCann?
There's no better jurisdiction for the NFL than New York because of Tom Brady. Because they beat Tom Brady, that's now binding precedent in New York. If this case winds up in New York, I don't see a pathway for Elliott to win because the judge is going to be obligated, even a sympathetic judge is going to be obligated to say the Tom Brady decision makes it clear unless there are procedural safeguards actually stated in Article 46, they don't exist.
Okay. So handicap it for me, I guess, to wrap it all up, Michael. Handicap this. What do you think is going to happen?
I think most likely by the end, Elliott loses, but it's hard to read what Judge Mazant's going to do. Clearly, during the hearing, based on the reporting, he was troubled by what happened in the NFL's investigation of Elliott. I don't think it's beyond the realm of possibility that he could issue a restraining order, but I don't think at the end Elliott will prevail just because Article 46 is so disadvantageous for players. Even if Elliott gets another couple weeks without a suspension, I think ultimately he'll serve it.
So you're saying most likely scenario he misses weeks 4 through 10? Is that what you're saying?
That or 2 through 8. I mean, I think that if he gets any win, it's probably going to be at this initial threshold because the judge could say, I have some concerns. I need to take more time to evaluate this. Let's basically put things on hold for a couple weeks with a restraining order. But I don't think that's the likely outcome, Rich. I think the likely outcome is that the judge probably denies the temporary restraining order. But I don't want to say that with conviction because ultimately it's really up to the judge and he has the discretion.
And then what do you think Jerry Jones does about this? Do you think that he's going to – because I know if you remember, Bob Kraft had a moment where he thought maybe he should continue to fight Tom Brady and perhaps sue the league and thought differently. But Jerry – with all honesty, he's got his bust in his jacket already in Canton. I'm wondering what you think Jerry Jones' remedies might be.
You know, the truth is, Rich, the law is stacked against owners suing the league. The fact is owners agree to the commissioner having final authority on player discipline and also on team discipline. I don't see a valid or realistic pathway for Jerry Jones to go to court trying to take on the NFL. I realize he sued the NFL before, back in the 90s,
yep.
That was over a totally different thing. That was really about intellectual property, who has the right to decide an exclusive licensing deal. That has nothing to do with this. This is about player conduct. If Jones goes to court, I don't think he will, and if he does, I don't think it would go anywhere.
Okay.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on radio stations across the country and audience.
If you like that, download our app. Please, just if it's a memory thing, just delete other apps. You don't need those apps. This app, the Rich Eisen Show app, you need that.